All right, what's up, guys? Welcome to 24 Hours of Daytona. Sorry you missed the first stint. Forgot to hit record. A lot going on, but just rolling out on our second stint. Just had a little hiccup. Fuller came in and missed our pit stall, so we basically had to coast around a whole nother lap. Made it in, right. Out of gas, and we're getting back out track, and we're seeing where we're at now. So. Looks like we're actually going to be about a lap down. That's racing. We still got 23 hours to go, so we're good. We'll get back up in there.
Left side. You're clear.
Man, we got that extra lap. So you just gotta really pay attention on pits. Just because if you mess it up, that's everything. But if you're going to have a mistake, you want to have it now. You want to have it when you got 23 hours of racing left to do.
Okay, so we got a slow wrecked HPD out already, huh?
Yes, number 19.
Of course, he's right around us. Good thing is we can maybe...
We already pitted, so he's going to be stuck like that for the whole race. Thanks, Irati.
Oh my gosh, dude. Why would Coanda do that?
24-hour race, Marcus. Don't have to be a shithead.
Just use him, you know? Just follow him and use him.
Right side.
But yeah, that was a pretty amateur move.
Clear.
So this is kind of good because we'll be able to use a faster car like we were before. Oh man, I thought he was going in there too fast.
He's about to spin.
Alright, let's see where we're at now. What position we're in. Oh, look like we lost too many spots. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 10, 11. We were in 11th, 12th, 13th, 14th, 15th. So we lost about 4 spots. It's our. Not ideal, but it's alright. What we gotta do now is get around the McLaren.
Step out real quick.
Left side. Still there.
Which is gonna, I hope, not be a complete pain.
Still there. Clear.
Alright, that worked out. Be right back.
So what'd we lose? 3 spots?
You just signed the fastest lap.
Ooh, getting close to that wall. How you doing, Dex? Sorry, you caught me at a bad moment there earlier when we were dealing with our pit stop dramas. Thanks for tuning in. Let's find out where the next position is relative to us. Not that far away. Is that the team that caused that wreck earlier? Nah, it's a different team.
Brad, I'll give it to you after the bus stop.
So they're right there, kind of cruising by themselves. What kind of time's he running? 47.1. The Shark team should be fast. I've raced with some of those guys before. Laura, this is one of the cars that got caught up in that early wreck. Poor guys. They're doing it their own. Well, they did put that picture on their car, so are they asking for it? That sucks. So it was like on the second lap, and going into turn one, a Beamer broke too late, took out another Beamer, and took out like four cars with it. That was one of them. That was another one, the car right behind him. That was another one that got taken out. And there we are.
Left side. You're clear. Right side, 46.01. Clear, clear, clear.
There's Eric. Be a long race for those guys. So early and already some cars damaged. I don't know if any HPD. Car bent up.
Back.
Alright, let's go see if our car's still in one piece. And yay. I've actually been able to gap Coanda a little bit, so I mean, we got pace, we just gotta be in the right place.
I see Danny Kane is in the pits and damage.
Whoa, what's going on? Oh, I'm on an HPD. I thought it was this car. That's scared. Like, why are we slowing down so much?
You guys gotta check how Danny got taken out. That's worth a protest.
Danny got taken out. Dang it, man.
Hey, this isn't league racing, baby. It's the jungle.
What's our car number?
902.
He's 902. Basically, the slow HPD that was cruising around the track was high on the oval. Just turned down and onto the pits. Onto the pits when Danny was passing. You just turn into him, blam!
Freaking idiots, dude. Those are teammates. P1. Wow. Freaking idiots, dude. Putting this guy on blast, I don't care.
On your right, clear.
Shame, Mark. Shame. Now he probably was pulling it back in to just stop racing. Wasn't paying attention. That's 24-hour racing, McSheeple. That's only the first hour, buddy. You gotta have a strong heart for this one. That's what makes it so much fun, though, is those... the highs and lows. That was our last lap. 46.4. John might be trying a little bit too hard right now, because I think he did just make a mistake going into one that let Marcus catch up, or Marcus just caught up because of the draft one or two. Maybe it was just because of the draft. I didn't actually see what happened to him. That's just when I rejoined. I don't know what Marcus's game plan is. I wish, like, it was the real world. I could go down and talk to our pit crew right now. Like, if you guys want to pass us, go ahead and pass us. We'll just sit right behind you.
On your left.
There we go.
Still there.
Well, found my new gas, man.
Clear.
Yes, sir.
46.8.
So hopefully we can just use him, use his draft, and that'll help pull us along. Let's go see what the car we're trying to track down now is paces. I wish in this menu it would say last lap ran for each team. Alright, their last lap was a 47.2. How far ahead are they? Are us? Or us? Are they? I need to get a stopwatch, is what I need. iPhone. Wait for it. We're live now. I just hit start at the start finish line with stopwatch. Try and find my car. 8 seconds behind him. And I think we're running a lot quicker. Oh, wrong way. Yep. Gonna give John a little update here. Winfield, time is right.
My new gas man's getting a little loose.
47.6. So we're a second faster. I'm not going to say anything until he gets on the straightaway, though. I just don't want to distract him. So we were 8 seconds behind him that last lap, and we're gaining, we were a second faster that last lap. All right, so we're 8 seconds behind the car for position next in front of us, and you were a second faster than him that lap.
Yeah, he's damaged.
I don't know how John knows that. I don't even know that. Must not been paying attention.
I think the gas man's getting sick of the blue flag.
Marcus ran 46.3 that last lap. Let's see what 47.5 again. I gotta move this camera too. It's just not gonna work.
On your left. Still there. All clear.
Lost the car for a second. Alright, now what was it actually doing? 47.5. 46.9, 47.5. Why'd we slow down? Why'd my camera move? There we go. Must have been at HPD's why we were slower. So it looks, is that the, no, that's not.
Clear.
I was wondering if we already could see that beamer that we're catching, but we can't. Looks like we lost that gap a little bit because of some HPD traffic to that BMW, which is going to hurt us. Might be hard to keep up right now. We're right on the edge of being able to keep this symbiotic relationship alive with this beamer. John has to get a pretty solid infield section here. Marcus probably has to make a mistake or two. So I believe that car is for like third place, second or third place right now. So you see we got decent pace. I mean, we're great on pace with the top cars. They're probably just a little bit quicker through the infield than we are.
Clear, clear, clear. Left side.
Adios.
Clear.
So just crazy sometimes. Now we definitely lost that draft. Sucks. Oh, and there that goes that guy that was just giving us a heart attack, spinning off on the bus stop.
Yeah, how come I'm not surprised to see that? You know, all the idiot HPD that's trying to stick it in everywhere goes off at the bus stop.
Left side, 46.38,
clear. We're keeping up. Keeping up. Pretty much the same gap we had last time when we had to deal with all that drama, so. Here comes some more drama.
Now he's gonna be damaged and crawling onto the track for 23 hours.
On your right. Clear.
46.3, you're cooking. That was a good lap right there. I really didn't think you ran that quick. He's moving right now. He's trying hard, that's for sure. .46.3 to .46.6. We'll see what Marcus does this lap. .46.2. Or .46.9. So he gained 8 tenths on this out lap. Dude, that looked like a good battle. What? That GT battle go. That's what I was looking at right here. It's on T. So this is probably where about we would have been if we didn't have that mishap. So let's see how far back we are from that. Well, I think we're a lap down, so we're like a lap. That hurts to say that we're a lap down, but it's alright. 23 hours left.
User joined your channel.
Back.
It's gonna be just about picking people off now.
Oh, they pulled me up for an interview.
He didn't ask you for a lap on board, no.
You're clear?
He asked for what?
I hate him.
It's a car we're catching right now. Let's see if is that car in front of him for position as well? No.
No, they were asking why
this
you
is
twice and why the hell we have a card with the name with the word moonshine in the title in the race as well.
I'm gonna
tell him it was because my crew didn't tell me where my stall was.
No,
or did
I
you just dump it on me?
I told him that you're so fast you're not used as a pit crew guy being so far down the lane.
I'm gonna set up your black book for next week's time.
There's our teammate just coming out of the pits right now. That's our P1 car coming out with damage now because of that idiot.
Left side. Clear.
46.5. What did Mr. Marcus run? 47.3.
I think Vitell's got the nice.
So we gained those 8 tenths back. We lost that last lap.
I think so.
McSheeple, can you go to the race spot live timing and tell me? We're a lap down. Because this guy right here, he's... Oh, wait. What happened to them? They're behind us. Wait, what happened to Coanda? They're on 29th, and we're in 25th.
Yeah, they're actually the BMW just ahead of us. I was about to ask that.
Do you know what happened to them?
No, I don't.
They don't even look like they have damage.
I see them twice in a pit lane.
I
see them twice.
I don't think we are a lap down. Now it wouldn't make sense that we were a lap down either because
disconnected. They got disconnected.
Oh, Jorn. Oh,
they got disconnected. That sucks. So Coanda is a lap down. Oh, and we get to use them. Yeah, we're not lap down.
Door quarter clear.
Thank you, sheep.
Oh, come on, Danny.
Oh, that's a good stretch. He probably doesn't know what he has yet, to be honest, to be fair.
Still there, door clear.
He's being good, though. He's a good boy. Alright, so we're on the lead lap. Sweet. Where are the leaders, then? Let's figure that out. Phew. Okay, so leaders are pretty close. We're almost a lap down, but it's all right. We're not a lap down. That's an important thing. Let's see where 10th place is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Mad Cow Racing, 10th place.
He must be pissed.
Let's see where we are.
Oh, I'm sure.
Oh, sure. It's going to be all right,
guys. I mean, that pressure is so bad.
We're not even that far.
Left side.
Like all the GT car that got wrecked in like turn one, like lap four.
Yeah, so far both wrecks I've seen, those two have been just some insanely noobish stuff.
That's a good job.
Like, they shouldn't be able to race in the next 24 hours. I'd almost stop talking over here, dude. You heard they had to take a tow to start or something?
Right side.
Huh.
Still there.
I'd be interested if something glitched. Alright, so we're cruising.
Oh, he's way down at top speed, too. Clear. He just blew past him. Oh, he's pulling it in. We're probably gonna call it.
47.95.
All because of an hour into the race, some dude pulled. Oh, man. I'm mad for him. Just because it was such a stupid incident. They're probably going to see if it fixes it anymore, but they're going to find out it doesn't. Alright, so we're just going to start chipping away positions now. Here's the next position we got to get right here. Getting real close. This might be positioned, no. Oh man, I'm so much happier now, I realize we're not that dumb. Yet.
On your right. Clear.
I love this camera shot. This is like if you're sitting on the top of the bleachers. Yep. Here, I'll actually just show you.
John is ready for the third stint.
Oops, wrong.
Maybe it's force, man.
Control F12. Basically, it was at the top of the bleachers up there.
You want me to do three?
Nah, I was just kidding.
I like being up there because it'd be like you're actually at the track. See what that view's like. That's what's cool about iRacing is you can go in here and find out what seat you like and get those tickets for the race.
It'll be where that interesting to see where that Coanda spaceship in front of us heads up.
So cruising along. I gotta look at that GT group there. That looks like they're. Oh, wrong button. Sorry. Oops. What? It's skipping. I must not have those cars rendered right now. I won't. Looks like his end plates are all. Man, both our race spot cars are beat up. Looks like our other prototype cars beat up.
Yeah, they both got beat up. The one with a little more and Benefield in it got hit really early on.
Guys are beat up.
Tandem drafting.
See, what'd he run last? 46.8 to what we run? 47 flat. Nobody behind us. It should be, look into the notes for the broadcast. Is there the little info box underneath the video? It'll have my race times there. How you doing, Smart Pizza? This is the camera I like. So we're all the way up on top of the spotter stand, basically. 46.6, what did Marcus run? 46.6. I think my first time driving's like 12 o'clock my time. Here, let me look at my spreadsheet real quick. Alt tabbed out. Where? Alright, my let's throw. My first stint is at 3 o'clock my time. A message. I think I have it wrong on the broadcast. Yeah, I'm retarded. I have it wrong. Just gonna put it. Yep. It's those are the right times. Those are just oh, that's right. My first stint's at 6 o'clock Eastern. Second stint's at 9 o'clock Eastern. Third stint's at 12 o'clock Eastern. That's easy to remember, honey. 3 o'clock my time, 6 o'clock Pacific, 9 o'clock Pacific, or 12 o'clock Pacific, 9 o'clock Pacific, 6 o'clock Pacific, or Eastern. Oh no, where'd all my info go on that screen? Hold on. Now alt tab again. I just lost like an entire window. Some of that, show me some of that. That. Yeah, no, I'm erasing all that stuff. That's all wrong. Let me just update it real quick. What'd I say? 6 p.m. to 9 to 12. Right from 12. I thought it was 11. I thought of my last stint was it? Is it 9 p.m. time? Oh, duh, those are all Eastern time. Duh. It's at 9 p.m. my time, so I'll be done at like 11 o'clock or 12 o'clock my time. All right. I updated the times. So they're correct now. I can watch some. Unless iRacing just crashed. Oh. Alright, what do we got here? Ooh, we're getting close to that position. That's for position right there. Let's get on board. Watch them track them down. Let's see, what'd he run last lap? 47.5. Trick is getting past him and keeping up with that Kalanda car. Not losing that Kalanda car.
Right side. Clear, clear. 46.49. Left side.
Some cars coming in from pit lane.
Clear by half.
Wait for it.
One on the right side.
Like the Glacier boys.
Still there. You're clear.
Yeah, now my first stint's in a long time. 5-8 hours. I thought it was sooner than that. Oh well. I'll double check. I'm sorry.
Leader pit road.
I'm confusing myself. Keep thinking I'm driving at 6 o'clock my time, I'm driving at 3 o'clock my time. So it's actually 10, 12. Yeah, I'm driving at 8 hours, which is fine. 3 o'clock, my first stint being at 3 o'clock is better than my first stint being at 6 o'clock.
On your right. Still there. Looks clear, clear, clear. 46.79.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, I kind of went to bed early last night, so I'll stay up through all the way through my stints, but I don't know if I'll stay up after that. It's kind of hard because once you go to sleep, it's hard to get back up for the end of the race, but you don't want to miss the end of the race, so I'll probably just somehow stay up for the end of the race. Stay up for 24 hours. I might try and take a little 30-minute nap or something in between stints. We'll see how I feel. Play it by ear. Hey, what's up, GT World? How you doing, bud? One of these days I'm going to do a whole 24-hour race. That's a ways away. John's not
still
actually
there.
Trying to pass right now.
5,
he's just
clear.
Getting
job.
As close to him as he can. We got that guy still behind us. But we have just gained one position, or second position is somewhere, I'm not sure where. I'll go find that out right now. Let's watch a lap here with John, actually.
Cheers to me.
How you doing today, GT World? The heck was that? It's something like out of a horror movie. Two kind of laps we run here. 47.3. Forty-seven six to his 47.3, but we caught up, so we're just pretty much hanging on. There's another damaged HPD coming back out on track. Damaged HPD behind you.
right side. Clear. Right side. Clear, clear.
Jesus.
You had to watch for him to do something stupid.
See, that's so silly, though, that the iRacing will repair a car and not put a front clip back on it. Like, what's going on, iRacing? That ain't cool, bros. Because he couldn't figure it out the first time. You're not fast enough to do that, bro. I kind of like I actually tried to pass us, even though he knows he's not faster than us. So this will be interesting to see how this whole infield plays out right now. If he tries to pass us here. Hey, what's up, bud? You are RB free.
On your right.
What an asshole. Sorry.
Clear.
Jake, why don't you get that thing
I
off
try
the
not
track.
Cuss
We're gonna
much,
get
but...
up and...
That's pretty stupid driving by that guy's part. Yeah, he shouldn't be on track right now.
I don't even think he's taking any repairs. Because with the update, like, it, the graphics have the nose back and stuff, and he's running without a nose.
That's the problem with the update. I mean, yeah, it's great, but if you're not going to fix the car completely, then what's the point? Right now what they're doing is they're repairing these HPDs, but they're not doing it the way they would actually in the real world, so they come back out and they're completely off speed, so now you got these roadblocks that can pass you, which is annoying. Right on, how's your race going, RB? And we lost our gap to Coanda and all them, so that sucks too. Alright, let's see where the next position is.
47.94.
Yeah, can you imagine? No. No, thank you. I'd rather pit it. I'd rather park it and go do something else on my day than drive a piece of junk around here for 23 hours. Bye-bye. It'd be nice if I think iRacing will eventually get it where they can fix the cars a lot better than this. This is just a quick patch, is what I'm hoping. All right, let's see if this Beamer in front of us is for position. Nope. It's like about ready to say, yep, nope. So let's go here and let's find our next position. So we're in 22nd. We're looking for 21st. There he is. 47.4. Ooh. A lot of positions right here. Nice little four car group. So that's probably the group we would have been in if we didn't have our incident. So we're getting back to where we were. Because we are right here. We'll get there. Well, starting 7th isn't bad. Where are you guys at now? You guys still got a car with fenders on it? You still
right
got
side.
Your... Can your car do your normal laps?
Right side clear.
There's we just passed that.
Maybe he gets it now.
I doubt it.
Ooh, Calanda goes out wide. Hopefully we can catch back up to them. I hope you guys still have all your fenders on them. If you're in 7th right now, just keep, you're beautiful, man. Just keep chugging away.
Right side. Clear. Very slow on the left. Keep coming.
Get that draft off that beamer in front of us. You ran in a 47 for that last lap. Yeah, start comparing lap times of the cars we're catching. So we ran a 46.9. We're trying to track down Brazil Power Team. That's funny because I think Shark Motorsports, the car we just passed, is from Brazil too.
Hey, JD.
So those are the car. That's the group we're tracking down. So they ran a 47.6 to our number.
On your left.
Are we 43?
Clear, clear, clear.
Our 46.9. We caught him by 8/10 that lap. You know, I don't know where those spots came from, Tom. Because it wouldn't be from pit stops. Those are positions overall. I think what's happening, a lot of HPDs have wrecked. They've done the repairs, they've gone out back on track, but they're still slow on the straight. So I think they're slowly retiring. So I think those are the positions we're gaining.
Definitely hilarious watching you just run from that HPD that's behind you.
Still there.
Because we've gained one spot since our this stint. But we're gaining on a group of cars right now. Let's see if we gained on them that lap. Yeah. Gained them on that lap too. Ooh, man. Let's watch this. Because all those GT cars you're seeing right there are cars are for position. All of them except for this McLaren right here. That's not for position. These are all for position. And here we are. We're getting closer. I'll just stick with it there, Roberto. Still got 22 hours and forever left. Actually, give me 2 seconds, guys. I'm gonna alt-tab real quick.
Well, it should be 5 laps when I cross the line.
Okay.
No, we're definitely catching a group of about 4 GTs in front of us. So. Actually, they kind of split up, but we're still catching.
Forty-nine. 7.12.
Caught him by, shoot, 1.7 seconds out lap. Yeah, we caught him by 1.7 seconds out lap. A lot of traffic, but we're still making real good progress right now.
Yeah, Eduardo's like the only real fast guy that's running like laps that, you know, you, me, and Fuller were all able to run. I haven't seen Patel run, so I don't know what he's doing. I have faith in you, though, Patel. Yeah, Eduardo's the only one I've seen run those kind of lap times.
Yep. That's the name of the game, Tom. Just chip, chip, chip away. Just race your race, and hope you got you did enough work during the week to have the pace to do what we're doing right now. All right, I will be right back. Take a restroom break.
Now we need an admin to get Jake the Snake Burton off the track.
Yeah, it'd be nice. Or at least go in and get some repairs.
No, it's not possible. Aero damage is not repaired yet. They just put up the bend part on your car. So if we damage our car, we're gonna be stuck with a slow car for the whole race.
Clear.
Yeah, I can't believe how long it's taking them to come out with like an actual repair model.
Right side. On your clear, clear. One on the right side. Four, clear. 47.18.
So what's it look like I'm going to do 35 laps this stint? I'll have two to go at the line.
Okay. I'll go for a quick pee. I'll be right back.
Our pit stall's a little farther up, so just watch out for that. I'm just messing with him.
46, 29,
he's probably saying things to himself about me right now. Alright, so how much have we caught the guys in front of us? There they are. Nope. There's 11th place. I'm so confused right now. How are we in 12th place? Oh, all the HPDs must have done their second pit stop. That's what it is. So that Ford GT is for position up there, and the car right behind us is not. Wait, I'm not sure. Oh, the car right behind us is for position. I missed that. What happened there? Maybe he's on brand new tires and he's a Porsche. Oh, those are the leaders, I think. They're first or second place. They have already done their pit stop. So yeah, you're already starting to see how much longer we can go in field than those guys. Plus, we got our extra lap last time.
Left side.
So they're there. On their third stint. We're just finishing our second stint.
Still there. Clear.
Ooh, that Ford's going.
All right, coming in next time by.
47.06.
Accidentally refreshed training paints. Coming in this time. Interesting to see where that other Ford comes out. Yeah, so I guess if you're still here, Roberto, you're getting those. We got a whole bunch of those black flag things when we did the spa race last week or 2 weeks ago. Just not even incidents and you're getting black flags. It's kind of annoying. Sorry, you guys.
JB, you back?
Uh-huh.
He's got to wait a second just to all keep
right.
us all
in suspense. Traction control's on. It's set to 3 for you.
Thank you.
Yeah, John runs his without traction control. JB runs his at 3. I run mine at 2. I don't know what Randy runs his at.
I never felt that nervous coming into a car. Oh.
Alright, let's go see where our competition is. We're doing pit change. So you saw John get out, you saw John get in.
Four excellent spins, my man.
Yeah, great.
Thanks,
job,
buddy. Yeah, real sorry, guys. I couldn't. There were so many damn cars that were in the pit stall, and I got my guy, single driver. He's painted up bright green, so he's easy to see, and I just didn't see him until it was too late.
Don't worry about it.
It's all good. You know, it's just one of those things we'll learn from, and we'll get that all synced up, and we'll always have a guy one color, and we'll always know where our pit stall is before the race starts. Stuff like that. Let's get better. That's all.
It's all right. We definitely got the pace to go forward, I think. I think in terms of driver lineup, I think we've been one of the more consistent teams I've seen run laps.
And
yeah, we'll be good.
Yeah, I mean, we're basically back up with the group we would have been with anyway, so yeah, it's whatever, man. Could have been a lot worse.
All right, good luck, JB. Just keep her on the track. Keep it clean.
This is the car.
I'll be right back.
Trying to race. Where are we?
I might be able to get some more talent as well.
There we are. This is going to be close. Ooh. We gained a position on the pit stop.
What was that?
I haven't done a turn yet, and I already get dive bomb.
I said we gained a position on the pit stop.
Definitely.
Actually, two at the moment. Be cool, JB. Be cool, bro. Whenever he finally goes for it, just let him have it. Dude's driving way too aggressive for the third hour of the race.
We might, there's like a period where if we're not sure if anyone's going to be around or wants to be around. Josh Chin's team wrecked out really early, already an hour in.
You're clear.
And I don't think he registered to the session, so we might be able to bring him in if we want to.
Well, tell him to start running practice laps. And I don't know if this setup's on our form.
I think there's two Brazilian and Italian behind me, so I don't feel like comfortable.
Well, don't do anything you don't feel comfortable doing, uncomfortable doing, so back out of it. I'm serious.
Yeah, I'll do that when they come by.
I don't care if we lose a couple of spots. I care if the car isn't running anymore. JB, he's good. He's got good pace. Smart kid. Yeah, all right. I'm just gonna do a little bit more coaching. Yeah, right now you should just do whatever feels most comfortable. That should be your decision making. What's up, John? Team lineup is Jonathan Boutel, Jonathan Fuller, and Randy Chenoweth. We might be bringing on a fifth driver because he got wrecked out, Joshua Chin, because he got wrecked out early and he hasn't registered for his car, so he can still register for our car. But he's going to need to run some practice. He's fast. I just want him to run some practice laps because he really hasn't. He's been driving, I think, a HPD all week. But he's really fast and he can pick up a car quick. So it's a good fifth driver to have for backup. How you doing today, by the way, Mr. Curtin? Looks like Boutel's using this Porsche successfully. Like John, same thing I was talking about earlier, where we just sit behind somebody and let them do the work. We've all four of us have kind of worked on that together. So,
hang on there, bud.
We all kind of the routine. 46.4, nice job, Jonathan. That's just as good as I'd be done right now. That's not true, but that's really good. That's very good. I'm just saying that because I had some really good sessions last night and I ran like a, I could run some 45, I think I ran a 45.3. And I could do a 45 flat if I just got the perfect toe and hit the infield really good. Here, let's see what my optimal is. Optimal, I've only been doing race fuel all week, and my optimal is a 44.6, so I haven't done one quality fuel run all week. It's nice, we're gapping those guys. He's kind of losing this guy a little bit, but let's see. He should catch up here by... I'm thinking he'll be really close to his bumper by the start-finish line. Gets through there beautifully. That's beautiful how he just got through the bus stop, dude. Nice speed.
Pull's good, baby.
Yeah, I knew you could do it. Keep it up. Good job. I was going to do something I was going to do. Yeah, it'll come back to me.
46.71.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. Slower down, slower down. Good job. He does like to swing it out a little bit wider there than I do, so... Sometimes I think he's overshooting the corner, but he's actually just running his line. So they ran a 46.9, we ran a 46.7, he ran a 46.4. That camera's not going to work.
All right, holding down 10th, huh?
Yeah,
we're actually not that far off, even
no,
with that
not.
That air, like just pace wise, we haven't. You gained a lot of time near stint, and JB definitely has pace, so I definitely think we're of all the drivers or of all the cars I saw in practice and all these teams, I saw quite a few of them. We are the best average I've seen in terms of pace across everybody. By the way, we might be bringing in some more talent. Josh Chin's team wrecked out in the very first stint. He never registered, so if he's available and we want him to, we can bring him in as well.
John, why don't you put up this setup on our farm? So
I already sent it to Josh on Facebook.
46.23.
Alright, what position is this guy in? So he's a lap behind us, if not more.
He said he wouldn't be available until 10 o'clock his time, because he's Eastern, though. Which is 7 for Hall and I. I think it's 9 for you 4.
Things are getting a little interesting right now. Okay, good to know about that Porsche. Thanks. That's true. He is on less fuel, huh? Good call. His tires are a little bit older, though. So you do have an HPD two cars behind you?
I'll try and pass this guy before I lose the leader.
HPD is behind you.
Right side. Still there. Clear.
That's Erica. Oh, it's not having a Mars. It's too
on your right.
Schwan, real fast car. There's the Porsche, so we pretty much lost that gap. It was unfortunate.
47.23.
That's a damage HPD.
Right side. Clear. That was a good job.
Go
right
one,
side.
Two, clear.
Still there. Clear.
Oof.
Clear.
Right.
Lost him now.
All right, good. It's all right.
Yeah. I got some really bad lapping.
He's he has less fuel on you too, so he's running a little bit later. All right, just settle into a nice base now. Looks like we're in 19th overall now. Trying to find the next car for position behind us. So this is the next car in position behind us. Or position behind us.
47.93.
Mario gets that run on you, you might just want to let him go.
Yeah, yeah. So it was faster.
Not really sure the dynamic of how this next stint's gonna play out as far as us catching anybody or anything like that.
Hmm.